because we're experts at language and communication. It's not what you say that matters, it's what your clients hear. Have you ever wondered when you get done with a conversation with a prospect or a client, you know, did they get it? Because what I would suggest is that in many cases, there may be a gap. You think you're saying one thing, they're actually hearing something different. This opportunity is, you know, I like to say that when you sit across the table from your clients, you hear what they tell you. They may nod their head, they may give you some feedback. What you don't get the opportunity to do is to see that bubble over their head. You don't know what they're thinking during this conversation. So we're going to get in that bubble.
I personally think that you need to be straightforward.
Get to know me first, ask me about me and my needs, and then if I don't understand it, then make an analogy.
I want to feel like I'm talking to somebody who's on my level, not somebody who's way up here, and I'm trying to grasp the meaning of what they're telling me.
We did focus groups all over the country, and so this is really the result of work with more than 300 prospects and clients in different areas around the country. But then I think the really interesting part is we're going to present them some messages. And these messages have been developed over the course of this research, and they all have handheld dials. And they get to react on a second-by-second basis to what they're hearing. You're going to start at 50, and you're going to react. And you're going to send a message to these people who are speaking on here, whether you like what you're hearing or whether you don't like what you're hearing. You're not going to be bashful, right? So if you like it, you're going to go up near the top. If you like it a lot. If you don't like it, you're going to go down near the bottom. And you're going to keep reacting on a second-by-second basis. We're focused on the message. You're going to see a lot of different messengers here. I want you to focus on what they're saying more than actually who it is that's saying it.
They're doing currency draft trading as well as doing a little bit of long, short, and global macro work. Because there's such an enormous amount of different investments, they will go away from the mainstream to the less efficient areas of the world.
It's my job to keep my eye on your portfolio. It's my job to know the risk each investment carries. As I seek out the best returns for your assets, it's my job to make sure that you have the right mix of assets to help you achieve your goals while keeping risk at a minimum. I do that by looking at your overall financial picture.
What I would say is that there's a lot about this language that truly is about the words that you use. That if you give it to anybody, new or old, with a lot of experience or not, kind of very client-driven or not, that the right language is going to make a difference. Beyond that, I think the right personality will certainly take things to the next level. But this component here was get the words right, because everybody can do it without having to change their personality.